time out of your busy week, whatever has held, and for coming and joining with us for a time of worship. We've loved playing together, and it's been a fun adventure. So please feel free to stand, to be seated, whatever you are comfortable with, and enjoy this time.
He's the prison-shaking Savior. If you got chains, If you can't feel. This is going to be James 1, verse 2 through 12. So, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness. And let that steadfastness have its full effect, that you may not be perfect and complete, but lacking in nothing. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask God, who gives it generously to all without reproach, and let it be given to him. But let him ask in faith, with no doubting, for the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea that is driven and tossed by the wind. For that person must not suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. He is a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. Let the lowly brother boast in his exaltation, and let the rich in his humiliation, because like a flower of the grass, he will pass away. For the sun rises with its scorching heat and withers with the grass. Its flower fails and its beauty perishes. So you will be the rich man, or so also will the rich man fade away in the midst of his pursuits. Blessed is the man who remains steadfast under trial, for when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life, which God has promised to those who love him.
This cornerstone. stop the light from getting through.
But we do.
Do you wish that you could see it all made new?
We do.
Revelation 5, 9 through 13. And they sang a new song, saying, "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you were slain. And with your blood you purchased for God persons from every tribe and language and people and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth." Then I looked and heard the voice of many angels, numbering thousands upon thousands, and 10,000 times 10,000. They encircled the throne and the living creatures and the elders. In a loud voice they were saying, "Worthy is the Lamb who is slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and on the sea and all that is in them saying, to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb, be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever.
Praise the Son. Praise the Son. Dear Heavenly Father, we just come to you tonight and want to lift you up at the end of this evening. God, you are worthy of our praise. And so many times we forget that and we get lost in the busyness of this week. But God, we just took a break here to lift you up. And I pray as we leave here that we leave encouraged, that we leave motivated to serve you throughout the rest of this week. Thank you for our time here tonight. In your name. Amen.
You.
Thanks for coming.